You get a new tip. Sairam.
Sir, Sairam.
Okay, please. Okay, Ajay, okay, get a new. Now, voice is audible.
Yeah? Sir, audible.
Can you, okay, okay, sir. Can you proceed? Okay.
Some numbers are in waiting, sir.
Waiting? No need of waiting, actually.
Okay, sir.
Actually, we have disabled that waiting room, sir. Okay? And the only thing is, we have gone fresh ID, and some people may struggle with the old ID. That is the only problem. Around 82 people have come. Okay, we'll see. Yes, sir, it is 81 only stand. Okay, we proceed.
Yeah.
కరెంట్ వచ్చింది
సార్. ఇన్ ద లాస్ట్ క్లాస్ యు ఆర్ స్టార్టెడ్ డిస్కసింగ్ అబౌట్ solving the problem using the steam tables, and I'll get back to here, and this is the starting, and if you are aware this h1 is equals to hf1 plus hfg1 and is equals to hg1, and that you are aware, and this and the next one is h1, you have got it like 2789.9. That is the case. And now we'll come to this one, h2, hf2 plus h2 hfg2. We have substituted the values of hf2 and hfg2, but we are not aware of h2. Find h2 is the process 1 to 2 is a isentropy process. Process 1 to 2 is a isentropy process. And so entropy at state 1 is equals to entropy at state 2. S1 is equals to S2. And then S1 is equals to SF1 plus SFG1, because at state 1 it is a dry saturated, and this is FG1. And S1 is equals to this much. And S2 is equals to SF2 plus X2 into SFG2. Now let us equate SF1 is equals to, sorry, not SF1, S1. It is equals to S1 is equals to S2, and S1 is given as 6.441, and please note down S1 is equals to S2. This is the key elements. Using this only, we are going to find the dryness fraction of this steam at a state 2. Okay, and in steam tables, we are able to find X2 using S1 minus S1 is equals to S2, whereas in Mollier chart, by drawing the vertical line, that is isentropic line as shown here. Yes, sir. By drawing this line, okay. Yes, this is the line. By drawing this line, okay. By drawing this line, we are able to identify what is the state 2, and X2 is found to be around 0.81. That already done it. So in Mollier chart, it is very simple. If you draw a vertical line and the intersection of this isentropic line as well as this P2, that is going to be state 2, and we are able to get the X2. But in case of your steam tables, definitely you have to solve this equation, that is S1 is equals to S2. S1 value is this much, and S2 value is this much, and ultimately you are going to get the value. Oh, yes, sir. S2 is equals to 1.06 plus 6.645 x2, and then you have to solve this equation and get me the value. Yes, sir. Yesterday also some people have given the value. Please, what is the value of x2, sir? All of you, please type it on your chart. Yes, please. 0.80, 0.814, 0.809. We should get 0.814 is mostly.
Yes, what exactly we had
earlier. Okay, let us wait for some more values. Ajad, are you there? Ajad. Ajat, please respond.
Sir, yes, sir.
Yesterday I have told you to consult your pupil regarding teaching methodology or difficulties or whatever it is. Have you had any meeting with your friends, classmates?
Sir.
And what is the outcome of that? And it is only to simplify our procedure, a rectification of our delivery method. What is the outcome of that one? Actually, I want to make all the people unmute at once. Maybe Saturday.
Sir, link invalid ID and also not sir. Malli no. Kaise tarvade ipudu?
Maybe they are going for older one.
Yes, sir.
Sir, malli pettan sir. Malli nenu. Adi kodan ipudu invalid ID and also not sir.
నేను షేర్ చేస్తాను చేస్తాను సార్ నేను
హలో హలో ఎస్ సార్
కొత్తది మళ్ళీ పెడితే అది అది కూడా ఇన్వాలిడ్ ఐడి అని వస్తుంది అని అంటున్నారు సార్
సరే అది టెక్నికల్ ప్రాబ్లమ్ అనుకుంటున్నాను యాక్చువల్లీ యు ఆర్ నాట్ ఎనీథింగ్ అండ్ ఆన్ ఎస్టర్డే వాట్ ఎవర్ ద మీటింగ్ షెడ్యూల్ ఈస్ నాట్ దేర్ ఇన్ అవర్ మీటింగ్స్ జస్ట్ నౌ ఐ హావ్ చెక్ ఇట్ అండ్ యు హావ్ క్రియేటెడ్ అండ్ వన్ సెకండ్ ఐ విల్ చెక్ ఇట్ వన్ సెకండ్ to go to the home. Okay, schedules, meetings, it is there sir. Hello, please write down the meeting ID. Hello, hello,
yes, sir.
847 8479023816216. Go with the third digit also. In case of Mollet chart, we are able to get up to only second digit only, approximation. Whereas in case of the steam tables, we'll get more exact values. Okay, and yes, sir, 0.809 is okay. Most of the people, sir, I have to go with a value of majority. Okay, and we'll go with that value 0.809. With this value, I'm proceeding, sir. Okay, okay. And you please note down. This is the value you have got it from your steam tables, and 0.81 is the value you have got from Mollet chart. Almost equal. So maybe slight difference is there. And then we'll go with the next one, that is let us have the H2 is equals to, yes sir, here you can see this is the H2. Now what is this, 317.7 plus, we'll make somewhat light. 317.7 plus 2319.2 into, yes sir, what is the next one sir? X2, that is 0.809. This is what exactly, and ultimately what is the outcome, that is the H2. Yes sir, 2193.93. Yes, 326. Okay, 2193.93 kilo joule per kg. And now we can have this heater ranking. Heater ranking is equal to, yes sir, the formula is H1 minus H2 divided by H1 minus HF2 into 100. When you ignore the pump work, sir, then you go with the substitution. Yes, the substitution H1 is almost, sir. Yeah, here I have got H1 value. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. This is the H1 value. No. 2789.9. Please type it, sir, so that what is the value of this one, sir? 2787.9. What is this, sir? I've got some. Okay. Minus H2 and 2193.93 divided by. Okay. So this is once again 2787.9 minus. What is the HF2, sir? HF2, please. 377. Yeah, somewhere. From your steam tables. Yeah. What is the HF2? 377.7. Yes, sir. It is equals to 317. Okay, sir.
0.7.
I have to move here and there, sir. Please, if you are able to give the value, it is easy for me. Okay, and then 317.7. Then yes, sir. Now we'll have this into 100. And what is the value of it? So much, 20. Come on, sir. 24.12. Okay. This is the value of got using steam tables, sir. This is the value of got with the steam tables. And with the Mollier chart, this, what is that value, sir? 24.26. Almost more or less same, sir. That's not a big issue. Okay. 24.04. It's not a big issue, sir. Okay. And 24.26 and 24.04 are one thing, whatever may be. And already I told you around 5% error is allowed using Mollier chart. That's why you have got that difference. And now we'll start finding plus and minus, positive and negatives. Pros and cons of this Mollier chart with respect to steam tables. Mollier chart, the procedure is simple and easy to complete it, and less time taking procedure. But there is a possibility of error in case of your Mollier chart. Whereas steam tables, it is a lengthy, tedious procedure, but you will get accurate values. This is what it is. Okay, sir, and we can proceed with this. And now, sir, so far you have seen that whatever the figure has shown, yes, sir, Yes, you can go like this. Now, just to get to this. Okay. And once you have this TS diagram, or this is the HS diagram, and we'll go with the TS diagram somewhere else. Yeah, somewhere else you are drawn. Yes. This is the TS diagram. And once again, I will draw the corresponding TS diagram. Yeah. Sir, so far you have seen this is a TS diagram with the different modes, and now we'll have it, okay? Let us say this is a T and this is S, and let us take this other. And so far you have seen this is this is 1, 2, 3, and 4. Sir, this TS diagram is given that at the end of this, this is what you call boiler. The end of this boiler, and this is condenser. The steam quality is, what is this quality, sir? It is a dry steam. And the steam supply from the boiler to the turbine, this is turbine, it may be not only a dry saturated as in the previous case, it may be superheated. If it is a superheated, then what could be the corresponding figure? Then the corresponding figure will be like this. Then it will go like this, and it will come like this, and join like this. That means 1' and 2". So you can check it, sir. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is dry steam. Next, 1', 2', 3, and 4 superheated. Okay, sir. Sometimes, sir, it may be wet also. In that case, sir, this is going to be like this. Okay, I'll have a different color. Yes. Then this is going to be, yes, sir, 2". This is going to be, sorry. This is 1'. Yeah. 1" and rather this line, that is equals to 2". Okay. Now the cycle 1", 2", 3, and 4. Okay, whatever it is. Okay. This is the one. The corresponding TS diagram, when you have the steam supplied to the turbine is initially wet, and this is the diagram when you are supplied with initially dry saturated steam, and this is the corresponding diagram when you are initially supplied with the superheated steam. So this is what exactly, and so far you have solved a problem in the initially the steam is initially dry saturated. Now we can have, okay, instead of x is equal to 1, if we make x is equal to 0.9, this will be the corresponding figure. And now let us solve a problem on steam whose initial condition is a superheated steam. Before going for this one, sir, let us have some properties of this steam. Let us have. Yeah, here you can see the same thing. So here 4, 1, 2 indicates this 1, 2 indicates mean to say yeah. Some red color will go with. One, two indicates dry saturated steam. Okay, the same thing you can see on TL diagram. This is the curve. So 1-2 has gone for different notations, sir. This is for wet. This is for superheated, and they are the corresponding on HS diagram. In HS diagram, we are going to study about only this 1-2, this 1-2, or this 1-2. These things only are going to draw. These things you are not going to worry about. Okay. That is the presentation of different steams: superheated, dry steam, and wet steam. And then, what are the different properties you have? Check it. Yes, sir. And here a comparison is shown. Here a comparison is given. Just a minute. Yes, sir. Some people are able to join. 101 is the strength as of now. Okay. In case of a Rankine Carnot cycle, the efficiency increases, if at all, the source temperature increases and sink temperature decreases. In the same manner, in case of our Rankine cycle also, the efficiency will increase if at all we are able to add heat at the highest mean temperature, and also increases if we decrease the rejection of the heat at the lowest temperature. So these two things you have to keep in mind. One is addition of heat at highest temperature will increase the pressure efficiency, and rejection of the heat at lowest temperature, that is also. But in case of our Carnot cycle, temperatures, because the process are constant temperature heat addition system and constant temperature heat rejection system are process. But whereas in our Rankine cycle, heat is added at constant pressure and heat is ejected at a constant pressure. So maximum pressure that at which you can add heat, and lowest pressure at which we can reject the heat. For that, you have one more point you have to keep in mind. Water has a triple point at 221.4 bar. Water has a triple point at 221.4. Let us go with the number of lines. Okay, they are the superheated steam. Yeah. This is 22. Yeah. Yes, a superheated steam. Now, all of you. Yes, sir. Once again, there is a problem. Yes. I'll come out of this. Yeah, we're getting some problem. 221 point, all of you check it. What is the maximum pressure you can have? Yes, this is the maximum pressure you are going to have it. And it equals to, yes, sir, you try to identify this point. Yes, sir. You go to the page number 14, sir. That is the 221.2 is the last value in pressure based steam tables. Some people may say that 221.4 or something else. And the corresponding temperature is a 374.1. And this is called as a triple point. At triple point, you can check it, sir. What is this HFG, sir? Zero. So where latent heat is going to be zero, that is the main point. Mean to say, water will be directly converted into steam without having this wet steam region. Okay, so what is the triple point of water? 221.2. Some people may say that 221.4 also, and 374.15 degrees centigrade. Mean to say, sir, the maximum pressure we can attain is at a constant temperature is 221.4 only. Okay, and thereafter you won't have the wet steam. Okay, directly we'll have the dry steam only. So if you want to add latent heat, the maximum pressure is going to be around 221 bar. That you have to keep in mind. And then we'll get back to this. Yes, sir. And now, that's why he has shown the efficiency is up to 225 bar, approximately 221 point something else. As the pressure increases, boiling point increases. As the pressure increases, boiling point increases, then automatically the efficiency will increase. And Carnot efficiency, Carnot cycle is having maximum efficiency when compared to Rankine cycle. The reason is, Carnot cycle is fully reversible when compared to Rankine cycle. And this is the curve where we can observe, that is, and here, this is specific steam consumption. Okay, a specific steam consumption low means it is going to give more, better performance. That is the important thing. So here you can observe, even though efficiency is good for Carnot cycle, but specific fuel consumption is low per Rankine cycle. Okay, mean to say, we'll get a more economy. You will get a more fuel economy, or we'll get more steam economy. This is what exactly you have to identify here. The reason is, in case of Carnot cycle, we may have to compress in wet region. Okay, so you have to compress the wet steam. For that, you may need some compressor. Whereas in Rankine cycle, compression is done only for the liquid, and we are going to use pump. Thereby, we are going to utilize very small amount of work. So the pump work WP is very small. Yeah, the WP is very small, then W net is more. Okay, this will be high, and because WP is less. Whereas Carnot cycle, as we are supposed to compress steam in wet condition, then more work is required. That's what happens in Rankine cycle. Okay, pump work is small, and network is more, thereby specific steam consumption is high. That's why practical, efficiency is different, sir. But mostly the practical application is specific steam consumption. It is less means this device is more economical. In case of our IC engines, SFC. If the SFC is low means more mileage. In the same manner, if SFC is low means we'll have better fuel economy. Better fuel economy, that you have to keep in mind. And then, various factors we are going to have. Yes, sir. some of the parameter which will influence the efficiency or performance of this Rankine cycle. The first one is boiler pressure. If you start increasing the boiler pressure, the efficiency starts increasing. Okay, and this will go till you will achieve the maximum efficiency of at 166 bar. That is the point you can observe. Yes, sir. Up to this point, there is the increase in efficiency, and further increase in pressure causes a drop. In general, we can say that if the boiler pressure increases, the efficiency of the Rankine cycle increases. That is the point you have to keep in mind. And then degree of the superheat. What do you mean by degree of superheat, sir? Yes, sir. After saturation temperature, how much? Okay. Raging temperature we are going to apply, that is called degree of superheat. If the degree of superheat increases, then the temperature at which heat added will increases, thereby the efficiency increases. Yes, sir. When the degree of superheat increases, then automatically, yes, sir. The average temperature at which steam heat is added will increase. The average temperature increases at which heat is added, then efficiency will increases. Then degree of superheat increasing means efficiency will increase. And this is not possible in case of your Carnot cycle. And then we'll go with the next option, the parameter. Yes, sir. This is condenser pressure. Condenser pressure, more or less, it is nothing but a sink. Okay, sir. If you want to have higher work ratio efficiency, P1 boiler pressure, P2 condenser pressure. Okay, sir. P1 should be, boiler pressure should be very high. Okay, and condenser pressure should be very low. So in the previous slide, you have seen that if the boiler pressure increases up to 166 MPa, okay, you are able to see that efficiency has increased. Now, if the condenser pressure, okay, sir, yes, sir, decreases, it is, okay, sir, condenser pressure, you may feel, what do you mean by increasing? Condenser pressure should be negative, sir. That's why it has shown, all of you. You may feel that it is increasing condenser pressure. What is meant by increasing pressure, sir? Okay, actually, it is decreasing condenser pressure. Why? Because atmosphere pressure is taken as a reference, and this is called as a condenser pressure. And this is called boiler pressure. So automatically, the distance from the atmosphere is increasing. So it doesn't mean it's not increasing the condenser pressure. It is nothing but what you call, sir, decreasing the condenser pressure. All of you, don't treat it as a increasing condenser pressure. Okay? This is not like that. This indicates condenser pressure is a subatmospheric pressure, less than atmospheric pressure. Less than means to say vacuum gauge reading. Increasing the vacuum gauge reading means decreasing the overall absolute pressure. Thereby, automatically what happens, sir, we'll get, what do you call, sir? Yes, efficiency. Okay. And now, if you keep on increasing, okay, sir, then automatically efficiency will increase. Okay, sir? Then ultimately, we can have two types of condenser measurements. Absolute one, and a relative one. If you take a relative one, if the pressure, okay, absolute one, if the pressure increases, then efficiency drops. If the pressure drops, the efficiency will increase on absolute scale. A relative, it is a difference, sir, as I told you previously. Are you able to see? If the condenser pressure decreases, efficiency increases. And what you call, sir, P2 is decreasing. And other way, it is, if the condenser pressure increases, then automatically efficiency decreases when you go with the absolute scale. If it is in relative scale, it will be different, as I told in the previous statement. This is what exactly. Ultimately, so some of the parameters are condenser pressure, boiler pressure, superheat. If the boiler pressure increases, then efficiency increases. If the condenser pressure decreases, efficiency increases. If the condenser pressure increases, then efficiency decreases. And the third one is, if the degree of superheat increases, then automatically, yes, it leads to increase in the efficiency of the system as shown. So sometimes you may ask us to write a short notes, okay, to denote influence upon Rankine cycle parameters on its performance. Okay, these things you have to show. Okay, and thereafter, yes, so far you have seen that the efficiency is found to be very less, around 25% or something else. So the efficiency of the Rankine cycle is very low. That's why what happens, people are trying to increase the performance of a Rankine cycle. For that, we are having different approaches, and methods to improve the performance of methods to improve the, please all of you know down, methods to improve the performance of Rankine cycle. Please try to note down, sir. I'm not going to write down. Okay. The methods to improve the performance of Rankine cycle. The first one is regeneration. Someone can type on. You can type it on chat also. The first procedure is regeneration.
Otherwise, I will go with that.
Regeneration. Okay. The second one, reheating. 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 Okay. Regeneration. Otherwise, I will write on, sir. Yes, sir. Methods to improve the performance. Okay. I will. The first one is regeneration. The only thing is I'm having a problem. Regeneration, the first one method. The second one is reheating. And the third one is binary vapor cycle. And the fourth one is water extraction. Water extraction. They are the four methods we are going to use to improve the performance of a Carnot cycle. Rankine cycle. And sir, even with a reheat, what you call, sir, superheating also, we are able to get the advantage of water extraction. Okay. And in the last slide, you have seen that. Yes, sir. Yeah, when you go with yes. One more point of increasing this efficiency. What is that efficiency, sir? Yes. Rankine cycle efficiency, degree of superheat. If the degree of superheat is more, then what happens at the end of expansion the turbine, you have seen that if something is like this, and we'll be having, this is the extraction. When this is the dry steam, sir, this is superheated steam. This is one, this is two, this is two dash dash. Now you can observe, with respect to two, at two dash will have more drainage fraction is more drainage fraction. Means what you call, sir, at this point, the steam will have less water content. less water particles. If the water particles are less, then the possibility of corrosion to the turbine blades will be minimized. So thereby what happens, sir, whatever the losses that are occurred due to corrosion, erosion of blades will reduce, thereby efficiency of the superheated steam will cycle will be more. That is one more point. Okay, sir? But whereas here it is around 0.8, sir, let us say, drainage fraction. But at this point, it is equals to 0.9. Then automatically the drainage fraction is more, means 0.9 kg is dry steam, only 0.1 kg is water. But here 0.2 kg is water. But when compared to this position, at this superheated steam, it will have better drainage fraction and low water particles, and then erosion and corrosion effect on the turbine blades will be less, and thereby what you call, sir, will be having better efficiency and better life also. There is also an important issue. Better life also is there, sir. This is what exactly we can observe in case of our superheated steam, sir. And we'll go with the various methods to improve the performance. And now let us have a problem. Okay. Let us record a problem based on the steam is initially superheated, sir. And last time, yes. Please note down problem. In a steam power plant cycle, Ajat, are you noting?
Sir.
In a steam power plant cycle, steam at 20 bar, previously solved it for 15 bar, so now we'll change it to 20 bar. Steam at 20 bar.
Yes,
so this is 20 bar. And 350 degrees centigrade is supplied. 350 degrees centigrade is supplied to the turbine and after expansion the steam is exhausted. State one, this is, sir. The steam is exhausted into a condenser. At a pressure of 0.05 bar. This is state two. 0.05 bar. Okay. Calculate network, comma, work ratio, comma, rank in efficiency, and specific steam consumption, SSC. Specific steam consumption. So we'll start the procedure, sir. Okay, now let us have this condition. Yes, sir. Now he has given the basic information that is equal to P1 is equal to, yes, sir, 20 bar. And what is the TS1 from your steam tables? Come on, sir. You have to tell it. What is the TS1 against the 20, okay, from steam tables? Please note, okay? So type in chart. What is the TS1 against the 20 bar? Yeah. Then I'll go with, yes, sir. Here it is. 20 bar. 212.4 is the corresponding value. Or in a position to infer, sir. From the steam tables, 20 bar. Yes, this is 20 bar. And the corresponding temperature is 212.4. Yes, we'll record it here. 212.4. Then as the temperature is given as 350, definitely this steam is called as the superheated steam. The reason is, as the temperature of this steam is greater than the saturation temperature, that's why it is called as a initially superheated steam. I'm not in a single response in your chart, sir. Huh? Okay, people are moving away. And now, okay, sir, let us identify how to plot it. So in this case, how to draw this figure on your Mollier chart? Okay. Draw the, yes, sir, this is the HS diagram. This is H, this is X, this is X is equals to 1. And now, first of all, identify what is the, yes, P is equals to 20 bar. This is P is equals to 20 bar. P is equal to, okay, sir. P1 is equals to 20 bar. This line you identify, sir, first of all. And then you go for, yes, sir, constant temperature line. I will go with this color. Here. Identify 350 degrees constant temperature line. It may be like this. Okay, this is T is equal to 350. And now you take this point, this you named as 1, and draw the horizontal line. And this you named as H1. And please tell me, what is this value? You got it? First of all, you identify this line. What is this line, sir? 20 bar pressure line. Then you identify 350 degrees constant temperature line, and then the intersection you make it as a point. You take it as this as a point, okay? And now you name it as state 1 and draw the horizontal line, and then you draw the, and you tell me what is the H1. This is the procedure you have to adapt it, sir. Yes, sir. And all of you will continue this problem in the next class. You try to practice this, identify the point 1, okay? And thereby you start solving the problem. Okay, sir, we'll continue in the next class. Ajat, you take the, what you call, screen shots of student attendance, okay? Ajat.
కంప్లీటెడ్ సార్.
ఓకే నైస్.